je vais faire de la magie.
London in the 19th century was a city of contrasts. There were the leisured rich, with their secure incomes and elegant lifestyle, and there were the desperately poor. Hyde Park Gate on January 25th, 1882. The tall house with its dark and narrow interior was to be her home until her father's death, some 22 years
ça
later.
Ça marque la profondeur ou quoi? Ou c'est les dates?
Both of her parents had been married before and had been widowed.
Et là, ça redisparaît.
Leslie Stephen was a man of many and varied talents. Like his father and grandfather before him, he was a writer. He also edited the Cornhill magazine for a number of years and was the first editor of the Dictionary of National Biography, a monumental work which includes biographies of all men of note in English history. Virginia was their third child, following Vanessa and Toby, and to be followed by Adrian. This meant a household of eight children, the older four separated from the younger by about 10 years.
Seven.
There were seven servants, all women, which was not an excessive number for a family of the size and status of the Stevens. In those days before any of the modern conveniences which have so changed the way in which people live. Through her earliest years, Virginia became familiar with London's streets and played often in Kensington Gardens, which were only 100 yards from her home. As she grew older, there would be skating on the long water in the park. The Stevens knew many of the literary and intellectual figures of the day. Throughout her childhood, Virginia would have encountered such people as Tennyson, George Eliot, and Henry James. As he talked, Henry James would tilt back his chair further and further as he became more and more involved in what he was saying. To the children's delight, he fell over backwards on one occasion, but still finished what he had to say, lying on his back.
Mel Gibson, isn't it?
The highlight of Virginia's year was the family holiday at St. Ives, where they spent several weeks every summer from her earliest childhood until she was 14.
Parce qu'en fait, sinon les bateaux ils peuvent pas passer.
Je peux pas le dire, ça sera pour l'intimité.
In the garden, they played croquet. This is the four-year-old Virginia, and the batsman is her brother, Adrian. By the time she was 10, her family were calling her the demon bowler, and her elder brother, Toby, thought her a better player than many of his contemporaries.
Yeah, they can eat sausages,
yeah.
Or, you know, baby
They had many visitors, from the famous, like Henry James and George Meredith, to the very young, like the future poet Rupert Brooke, who was an enthusiastic participant in the daily games of cricket. The children mixed little with everyday life in St. Ives, preferring their own company. But Virginia derived great joy from the physical surroundings.
De la barre au Maltin, c'est la dynamique.
The two girls were not. In those days, boys went to school and university, but even in such an intellectually active and enlightened family as this, girls were expected merely to acquire the necessary accomplishments and marry. Vanessa and Virginia were educated at home by their parents. By all accounts, they were poor teachers, seemingly unable to understand how children could find difficult things which to them were obvious. Both lost their tempers easily, so it fell to the girls to educate themselves. Virginia always felt the lack of a formal education, but the rigorous course of reading she set herself must have been almost more appropriate to her eventual career as a writer.
It's a little bit cold.
Yeah, and it was cold for the Romans too.
She was a sensitive child, but although she was late in learning to speak,
therefore, example taken by me, and sell the gold of myself.
She was accident-prone and excitable, sometimes wild and praise one another. In 1891, they started a handwritten magazine, the weekly Hyde Park Gate News, which reported incidents in the household. Julia Stephen died in 1895, aged only 49. As if her mother's death was not enough for the naturally oversensitive Virginia, her father was so overcome with grief and self-pity that he made no attempt to come to terms with his loss. Virginia had her first nervous breakdown. The lot of looking after her. Soon she became engaged. Her stepfather was not prepared actually to stop the marriage, but the prospect of losing his new prop so soon after losing Julia.
Should we take a picture of you three?
A compromise was reached. Stella married, and she was gloriously happy for 3 short months before she died.